Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial. So in the last tutorial, I have discussed about using an introduction to the navigation driver activity. So as I have said before, we are going to learn about the fragment in Android Studio. Let's get started. So we have the Android Studio here. So before getting started, I just want to say what is a fragment. So fragment is something that can able to make your app a transparent item. In the last tutorial, I have said that in just a single activity, we can able to switch into multiple windows with the help of a fragment activity. By keeping a activity a static one, like if we are taking the example as the activity main or the content main, we will be keeping that content main as a static activity, and above that we are going to add a different kind of fragment layout files along with the corresponding layout activity for that layout file. So likewise, we are going to introduce the fragment. So the main use of the fragment is in case of the navigation drawer, as we have discussed in the last tutorial. And not only in the navigation drawer, we also use the fragment in the tabbed activity, bottom navigation activity, and many other places. Even the Google map and many other things use the fragment activity. So fragment, if you have a knowledge in what is a fragment and how you can able to use it in an Android app, then you got almost a basic idea of how an Android app is working. So in our daily life, as I have discussed before, in our daily life we use many applications, and most of the application really using fragments. And yeah, today we are going to learn about it. So I know that fragment is a little bit confusing one, so I'm going to show you and explain it in one or two different tutorials. So this is just a basic into this fragment and just an introduction, and the coming tutorial we will be learning about how to use that fragment into this navigation drawer activity and switch from one fragment to another using the navigation drawer items. So first of all, in order to get started, we have the a blank activity, which is a navigation drawer activity, same as that from the last tutorial, and we have the main activity and many other layout files. So the first thing is that we have to create a new layout and a new Java class for a single fragment. So I'm going to create a new layout. Right click on the layout, going to new, creating layout resource, and I just want to give the name for this first fragment as fragment. Oops. Okay, fragment one, maybe underscore one. Okay, so now we have a layout file which is named as fragment underscore one dot xml file. So taking the text, we have everything same. I'm going to arrange this, so pressing the Control Alt L. Now it's a little bit arranged. Closing that, and I just want to create two or three fragments, so I'm going to create the second and third. Okay, so now we have three different fragments. One is the fragment 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we have three of them. So now we have to create the corresponding activity file for each of these layered files. So first of all, I'm going to create for this fragment underscore one. So right click on the Java file, Java folder, right click on that, go to new, then go to the Java class. Now we have to give a name. I just want to give the first class as fragment one. Okay, so fragment one, and we'll be just copying the same thing into fragment 2 and 3. So we have to, first of all, we have to add all these lines required for this fragment, and the lines required for just getting this layout file. So now we got a public class fragment one, and what we have to do is that this is not just a simple activity, so we have to introduce the fragment into this activity file. So what we have to do is simply add this extend then fragment. So now this activity can able to introduce layout from the fragments, and once that done, all we have to do is inside this curly braces, we have to add the lines required to get the layout files and customizing it. So in the normal cases, we have seen one create as the method that introduced the set content view and which catches the layout file. So in this case of a fragment, we have to use the one create view and the one view created methods. So for that, all you have to do is right click between these two curly braces. So I'm just right clicking over here. Now go to the generate. You can also get it by just pressing the alt enter. And inside this small window, you have seen a lot of options, and not a lot of, just some options. And from that, all you have to do is just go to this override methods, which can be opened by just pressing the Control O. I'm just double clicking, and here it is. And all you have to do is from this, you have to find one create view, one create. Just you can also search one create. So yeah, here it is, one create view and one view creator. All we have to do is keep pressing the control on the keyboard. I'm going to select both of these and clicking the OK, and here we go. Now it automatically generated the methods and all other things. I'm going to remove this this text. I don't want it, because maybe you don't want it, because I'm going to teach you all of the things. So now we have two different kind of methods. One is the one create view and the second one is one view creator. And inside that we have the layout inflator with a variable name as inflator. So the layout inflator is going to inflate that layout file into this particular activity file. So we have view group, then bundle, and many other things. We'll be discussing the view group and the bundle in the upcoming tutorials regarding this fragment. In this tutorial, we are going to inflate the layout into this activity, and we are going to set up this layout. So we already have created the layout. Now we have to inflate that layout into this fragment so that you can able to control the items in this layout using this fragment corresponding to that layout file. So all we have to do is you have to just remove some of the lines. So here you can see it returns super one create view. There is no layout file added. So we have to remove this line in order to add the new line that catches the layout file. So we have to return, then we have to inflate that. So inflate. And the layout file r.layout.fragment1. Okay, so after that we have to just add comma, and as it is required by this one create view method. So comma, then container, again comma, and bundle saver instance. I just leaving it as false, and I will be discussing about this false and container in the upcoming tutorials. And finally closing that. Now yeah, we have inflated the layout file, which is fragment one, and now here it is. All we have to do is simply copy the fragment one and replace just the one with two and three for the corresponding layout file. So I'm just pressing Control. After selecting this fragment one layout activity file, I'm going to press F5 on the keyboard to copy that class. You can also press Ctrl C and Ctrl V, but I guess that F5 is better so that you can able to change the name. I'm going to add the 2. Now in this case we have to replace this with 2. So now we have the three different fragments. One is the fragment 3, fragment 2, and fragment 1, and that's it. So in the next tutorial, we are going to use this fragment into our navigation drawer item, and once that user press each of the item, then user can able to switch from one fragment to another. So yeah, also I'll be also adding the link, all these source codes, in my website, which is texedraw.com, which is actually under construction. So as soon as possible, I will be adding all the source codes in my website so that you can able to easily navigate it and just download it if you just want, and if you're such a lazy person to write all these codes. But anyways, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video.